dear friends. Today, we are going to review a Hollywood movie, Freelance. Freelance is barely a movie. Sure, it's got a budget, a semblance of a plot and stars that you will recognize, but none of it was developed beyond the bare minimum to get released on VOD and in a few theaters. It's a definitely lazy work, a project that echoes better films when it's doing anything. The most impressive thing about Pierre Morel's film is how it takes two actors as generally likable as John Cena and Alison Brie and makes them such bland avatars for actual people that they feed into the dull background of action comedy noise this movie tries to achieve. John Cena plays the AI name-generated Mason, a former special ops soldier who is introduced on a mission gone horribly awry. So after all, he needs some trauma as a defining character trait. Well, that ain't a rocky marriage, ain't. Consistently quizzical look, like when my dog hears a word she knows. Sorry. Mason is approached by his former boss for a job as the bodyguard for a journalist named Claire Wellington. And she travels to a fictional war-torn country named Poldonia to interview the president, John Vanegas. Shortly after arrival, they are thrust into action when they get stuck in an assassination attempt and coup on President Vanegas, sending them into the jungles of this make-believe country with no identity or history that can be seen on screen at all other than foreign place. So there's an oppressive nothingness to Freelance. No romance, no comedy, no action. Sure, there are half-hearted attempts at both those things, but none of it connects because this film doesn't have an ounce of artistry behind it. I'm a sucker for a fun rom-com adventure movie. Even kinda liked The Lost City, and a fan of John Cena's brand of action hero in most of Brie's entire career, and I found that the experience of Freelance draining. The various parts needed for a film like this, chemistry between performers, believable stakes, unexpected action beats are missing. So it's like watching an outline for a film instead of the final product. The opposite was once true for Morel, who burst onto the scene with District 13, a movie that explodes with life in every frame. He then cemented his potential as an international action director with Taken. But that filmmaker appears to have been sended down by the industry, left here to paint by numbers with boring cinematography and complete lack of cultural depth and uninspired action. At a certain point, even the actors start to look bored when Brie's character says, "That's pretty cool." And look, as Cena's like, "Both of them know they are in a movie," I muttered, "I don't believe you." Pierre Morel's Freelance follows disgraced American journalist Claire Wellington and her ex-military bodyguard, Mason, as he escorts her to the fictional South American country of Paldonia for an exclusive interview with its dark dictator, Juan Vanegas. While the film starts out by presenting Paldonia and its leader as unrepentantly evil, among other things, we are told that Vanegas is responsible for the death of half of Mason's former squad years earlier. It eventually reveals that various imperialist forces and corporate-funded mercenary groups have been actively undermining Vanegas as a means of forcing him to sell valuable natural resources for a cheaper rate. That's a surprising turn of events, especially for an action comedy given Hollywood's typically simplistic representations of underdeveloped countries whose conditions are presented as justification for American intervention. Sorry. Regrettably, that's the only surprise to be found in Jacob Lentz's screenplay, whose stabs at humor are so poorly conceived that they rarely qualify as such, and even when they do, they're more likely to elicit groans, such as a recurring and painfully ironic crack about Mason being petite. So what's worse, though, is the haphazard manner with which the filmmakers constantly juxtapose these lighter moments with more dire scenarios, with the former frequently undercutting the latter's intended gravitas. The film's romance plot, such as it is no less egregious, and in no small part due to the void of chemistry between the three leads. The few times that Vanegas hits on Claire are meant to show him as both charming and non-threatening when he is actually just over-objectifying her. Meanwhile, the inevitable flirtations between Claire and Mason not only come out of nowhere, but are swiftly cut short when Mason realizes that he is still in love with his estranged wife. So such a quad and ultimately pointless scenes are par for the course in Freelance, a film that doesn't seem to know what it wants to be. By its conclusion, what we are left with is a cinematic Frankenstein, whose disparate genre elements have been cobbled together without much consideration or fuss. As such, the film ultimately feels as aimless as it does airless. Too bleak for its more serious messaging, too lent, and not nearly funny enough to make you forget it. You know, I often try not to judge a book by its cover, but when I saw the poster for Freelance, I didn't have high hopes. John Cena is always cast in the same role, and though I usually enjoy it, I had a bad feeling from the start, unfortunately. My intuition was very, very right. The premise is simple and has been done before. Many times, even as recently as The Last City with Sandra Bullock, Channing Tatum, and Daniel Radcliffe in Freelance. John Cena plays Mason, a retired special force op who had a traumatic accident, now living an unfulfilling suburban life with a failing marriage. He takes a one-time job to protect a tarnished journalist. Mason is protecting Claire as she heads out to give an exclusive interview to dictator Juan Vanegas. So within hours of being there, a military coup breaks out and they need to fight their way to safety. Basically, girl needs protection. Boy protects girl. Some semblance of an attempted love story. The end. But with a political spin that had me a bit worried at the start. The beginning of Freelance is all shot with what looks like a low-quality GoPro, aiming to put us in Mason's shoes and go through what he is going through. The shaky camera style really just felt subpar. It was more distracting than anything. I felt like dictator Pierre Morel wanted us to feel a lot more than we did. Freelance had a tendency to feel like the team was aiming for a hardcore action film with a new laughs here and there, when in reality, it felt like I was watching a high-budget Ernest Goes to the Jungle film. I have enjoyed Cena's performance in things like The Suicide Squad and Vacation Friends. But in Freelance, it felt like he was a parody of himself. I often thought that instead of a special ops performance, Cena was giving us more WWE than anything. Whether it was the direction, writing, or acting itself, I can't quite pin down, but poorly timed jokes, cartoon-like facial expressions, and next to no chemistry with anyone in the film made a film I knew would be campy, downright brutal to sit through. The only time I felt Cena did have chemistry in the film was during the outtakes when he had a playful back and forth with Juan Pablo Raba, who plays John Vanegas. The hardest I laughed during the whole film. I adore Alison Brie and love that she is being considered for sexy leading woman roles rather than the sweet and innocent girl next door we usually see from her. However, nothing about the script or chemistry in Freelance really gave her a chance to show that off. So there is a scene where Claire tries to entice Mason, and it is just an awkward moment no one wants to be part of. So there were creative choices not to follow the usual formula in a movie of this type, where boy falls for girl. Though I can see They were trying to break the mold here and make Mason a family man. I almost wish they had have just gone for it, so we could see some connection between these characters. Vanegas often hits her on her, and she seems flattered but and tries to further the relationship with Mason, which makes little to no sense. Speaking of Vanegas, John Pablo Raba was for by far the best part of Freelance. His character is lovable even though, from the beginning, we are set up to avoid trusting him. So his comedic timing is on par point, and he carries most of the scenes he is in, even when every performance around him falters. Usually, this kind of action comedy brings a certain level of cheesiness to the screen, but is often saved by big budget special effects. Unfortunately for Freelance, its massive budget couldn't save it. During several scenes, I was taken back by how bad that CGI was. In one scene, a helicopter comes crashing down, only to have a small branch on a fallen log completely stop the helicopter blades from spinning. So the practical effects weren't better, with blood spurting being completely unconvincing. Oh, and Christian Slater was there too, but we know why. Absolutely not. He likely shot the majority of his performance in one sitting. The average Joey could have played his character off the street and viewers wouldn't have batted an eye. So his character was yet another attempt at misdirection, and he just left me asking why. I will say that The Freelancer brings a bit of political spin into this story. While, with other words, current climate, I thought the film would be trending dangerous waters, it was a new take that showed different sides of the political story. Do I think people will be happy? We want to sympathize with the dictator? Probably not, but I did. Yep. I also enjoyed the final showdown, though I don't believe it was entirely logical. It was a welcomed, fresh take. Freelance tried to take a familiar action comedy formula and bend and shape it into something new, with moments that felt like the team was taking itself too seriously. Performances that felt like no more than slapstick comedy, and special effects that ripped viewers out of the moment I had called Freelance the most miss this year. So it's never a good thing when the blooper reel running over a movie's credits demonstrates more energy, humor, and charisma than the preceding 2 hours. Sorry. So which is unfortunately the case with Pierre Morel's action comedy Freelance. It isn't until the credit rolls that we see a bit of spark from the usually delightful Alison Brie, or evidence that John Cena can riff. So there is also a telltale clue in these bloopers as well. A green screen shot with a bit of foliage dangling in the corner of the frame as John Pablo Raga mugs for the camera, which explains why so many exterior shots look so uncanny. Finally, everything about Freelance starts to make sense. Or does it make even less sense? The confounding, bizarre, and punishingly dull Freelance isn't really a comedy. And while there is some action, nothing ever gets the blood pumping. But it looks and sounds like an action comedy in the vein of The Lost City, which was, of course, made in the mold of Romancing the Stone. But the script by Jacob Lentz clearly wanted to be more of a serious political commentary before it was molded to fit the capabilities of its stars. John Cena stars as Mason, whom we get to know in a series of POV shots in the opening credits. A rambunctious kid who just wants to help people, he ends up going the traditional route and becoming a lawyer and getting married before he gives it up for boot camp and in a tour in the special forces. A tragic incident in the fictional South American country of Poldonia leaves him injured and grieving, and he is grounded back in the suburbs with his wife and kid, working as a lawyer and battling suburban ennui. He is called back up by his buddy Sebastian to work a private security gig for disgraced journalist Claire Wellington, who is trying to get back on her feet by landing a coveted interview with Paldonian President Venegas. On the outs with his family, Mason jumps at the chance. Paldonia, you see, if you can't see the mid-film reveal coming a mile away, it's time to watch more movies. So this is all the tortured but swift setup to get where we are going. John Cena and Alison Brie dashing through the jungle under heavy artillery fires, courtesy of a conveniently timed military coup. So Cena and Brie sweetly arguing in the jungle with occasional gun battles. That's why we're all here, right? So this brightly lit, green screen heavy film is laden with overused tropes, but light on energy and char. So there was a Latin lover, President Venegas, with blindly white teeth to match his crisp white suit, and the sultry journalist, a career mad woman who will stop at nothing for her scoop, dictate, except for maybe a role in the he with whichever man is sleeping closest to her. So there is the bad guy who details all of his past wrongdoings to the hero while in the middle of a brawl. Undergirding all of this is a surprisingly cynical political story about the outside influence of global corporate entities in South America, the exploitation of natural resources in vulnerable countries, and optically driven political machinations in the vein of wag the dog. It feels like Lentz's script could have been something far darker and more savagely satirical, but instead, Freelance is this incredibly goofy jumble of tones, a movie that doesn't know what it is or what it wants to be, flailing about as it far overstays its welcome. So there's no need to hire this contractor. Freelance is an insipid amalgamation of tired action tropes and lackluster comedy. This movie is strung together by both a paper-thin plot and an uninspired direction. From start to finish, the film is an exercise in mediocrity, offering nothing more than a jumbled mess of cliches and wooden performances. Freelance plot, if it can even be called that, evolves around Mason. Mason is a retired special forces operator, turned bodyguard, tasked with protecting journalist Claire Wellington. So Claire is on an active assignment to conduct an interview with President John Venegas of the fictional nation of Paldonia. Sorry. A predictable coup erupts in the nation, and the trio finds themselves escaping into the jungle. A trio then finds themselves setting off on a journey that lacks any sense of actual urgency or tension. So one of the most glaring issues with Freelance is its complete lack of originality. So the film shamelessly borrows elements from countless other action comedies. The problem is that Freelance fails to introduce anything fresh or new into its narrative to help. So the characters are flat out one-dimensional. Mason is the typical brooding action hero, and Claire Wellington is the worn-out damsel in distress stereotyped. Even the attempt to introduce an AI-generated character falls flat, adding nothing substantial to the storytelling. Pierre Morel, once celebrated for his energetic direction in the films like District 13 and Taken, delivers a shockingly lackluster performance here. The action sequences lack the adrenaline-pumping excitement that Morel was once known for. Instead, in Freelance, we see a formulaic approach that fails to deliver anything engaging to the audience. The cinematography is equally uninspired, with generic shots of the jungle failing to capture any sense of awe or wonder. The lack of culture nuance in portraying Paldonia as a faceless generic foreign land further highlights film's lazy approach to world building. The performances in Freelance are as lifeless as the script itself. John Cena, known for his charisma and physicality, sleepwalks through the role of Mason. His attempts at emotional depth come across as forced, and his chemistry with Alison Brie's character is non-existent. Brie, despite her talent, is given little to work with. She is reduced to delivering lines devoid of any genuine emotion or wit. The supporting cast, including Juan Pablo Raba, is equally forgettable, and their performances are overshadowed by the film's lackluster writing. The attempts at humor in Freelance are cringeworthy at best, relying on tired jokes and awkward situations that fail to elicit genuine laughter. The romantic subplot between Mason and Claire is forced and lacks any semblance of chemistry, making it difficult to invest in their relationship or care about their fate. Freelance is a prime example of how not to make an action comedy film. It lacks originality, energy, and emotional depth, resulting in a viewing experience that is both tedious and forgettable. For audiences seeking a genuinely entertaining and well-crafted action comedy, Freelance is a hard pass. Save your time and money for a time film that offers something more than a haphazard assembly of tired clichés and uninspired performances. Attentive viewers will discern some positive moral values underlying the plot of the action comedy Freelance. The difficulty is that such audience concentration on this slipshod film will also reveal its subpar status, even as a source of casual entertainment. John Cena starts as He-Man Mason, as explained in an opening voiceover, convinced that he would be bored with family life in the suburbs. Youthful law school student Mason suddenly abandoned his studies to become an Army Ranger instead. Unlikely choice turned out to be a good one, since Mason loved being in the military. But when a mission to overthrow Juan Venegas, the notorious dictator of the fictional South American nation of Caledonia, went horribly awry, Mason was so badly wounded that he had to leave the service and return to the civilian world. Fast forward to the present, and Mason has acquired a wife Jenny, and a daughter Cassie. But his career has stayed stalled, and he is so stultified and restless that it's taking a lot on his marriage. So when his friend and former comrade Sebastian, who now has a security outfit, offers him a temporary job, Mason is initially open to the idea. However, on learning that his task will be to serve as bodyguard to reporter Claire Wellington during a journey to Caledonia, where Venegas has offered the journalist a rare interview, Mason hesitates when Sebastian throws a large fee into the balance, though he does the trick and Mason agrees to that. No sooner do Mason and Claire land in Caledonia than a coup breaks out and the presidential limo in which they are riding is ambushed. Predictably, Mason succeeds in beating back the onslaught and saving both Claire and Venegas. But this leaves the trio wandering around in the jungle while Mason trades fire with uniformed extras to no particular purpose. As scripted by Jacob Lentz and directed by Pierre Morel, Freelance eventually pushes back against Mason's cynicism about domestic tranquility, vindicating the value of marital fidelity and clan reconciliation. But the movie's forays into geopolitics and global economics are naively simplistic, with America depicted as the world's manipulative bad guy. So by the time the credits roll, Morel has staged a large-scale climactic showdown that litters the ground with corpses and the gunplay by which they and their numerous predecessors in early scenes are laid low is sometimes quite graphic. So blending this mayhem with humor drawing when Vanegas' savvy and the cross purposes at which Mason and Claire are constantly working makes for an unstable tone, seemingly uncertain where it wants to end up. The picture spins its wheels and in the end goes nowhere. The film contains considerable violence, brief rear nudity, anatomical humor, a couple of profanities, a few milder oaths. Travel uses each of rough and crude language and an obscene gesture. The OSV News classification is A3 adults, So Motion Picture Association rating is R, restricted. Under 17 requires accompanying parents or adult guardians. So it's never a good thing when the blogger reel running over a movie's credits demonstrates more energy, humor, and charisma than the preceding 2 hours, which is unfortunately the case with Pierre Morel's action comedy Freelance. It isn't until the credits roll that we see a bit of spark from the usually delightful Alison Brie, or evidence that John Cena can riff. There is also a telltale clue in these bloopers as well. A green screen studio shot with a bit of foliage dangling in the corner of the frame as Juan Pablo Raga mugs for the camera, which explains why so many exterior shots look so uncanny. Finally, everything about Freelance starts to make sense. Or does it make even less sense? The confounding, bizarre, and punishingly dull Freelance isn't really a comedy. And while there is some action, nothing ever gets the blood pumping. But it looks and sounds like an action comedy, and in the vein of The Lost City, which was of course made in the mold of Romancing the Stone. But the script by Jacob Lentz clearly wanted to be more of a serious political commentary, because before it was shaped to fit the capabilities of its stars. Cena stars as Mason, whom we get to know in a series of POV shots in the opening credits. An ambitious kid who just wants to help people. He ends up going the traditional route and becoming a lawyer and getting married before he gives it up for boot camp and a tour in a special forces. A tragic incident in the fictional South American country of Paldonia leaves him injured and grieving, and he is grounded back in the suburbs with his wife and kid, working as an attorney and battling suburban ennui. This brightly fit film is laden with overused tropes but light on energy and charm. So there was a Latin lover President Venegas with blindly white teeth to match his crisp white suit, and a sultry journalist, a career mad woman who will stop at nothing for her scoop data, except for maybe a role in the hay with whichever man is sleeping closest to her. So there was a bad guy who details all of his past wrongdoings to the hero while in the middle of a brawl. Undergirding all of this is a surprisingly cynical political story about the outsized influence of global corporate entities in South America, exploitation of natural resources in vulnerable countries, and optically driven political machinations in the vein of Wag the Dog. Sorry. It feels like Lang's script could have been something far darker and more savagely satirical. But instead, Freelance is an incredibly goofy jumble of tones, flailing about. As it overstays its welcome, there is no need to hire this contractor. Freelance is barely a movie. Sure, it's got a budget, a semblance of a plot and stars that you will recognize, but none of it was developed beyond the bare minimum to get released on VOD and in a few theaters. It's a definitely lazy work, a project that echoes better films when it's doing anything. The most impressive thing about Pierre Morel's film is how it takes two actors as generally likable as John Cena and Alison Brie and makes them such blind avatars for actual people that they feed into the dull background of action comedy noise this movie tries to achieve. John Cena plays the AI name generated Mason, a former special ops soldier who is introduced on a mission gone horribly awry. So after all, he needs some trauma as a defining character trait. Well, that ain't a rocky marriage, ain't. Consistently quizzical look, like when my dog hears a word she knows. Sorry. Mason is approached by his former boss for a job as the bodyguard for a journalist named Claire Wellington. And she travels to a fictional war-torn country named Paldonia to interview the president, John Venegas. Shortly after arrival, they are thrust into action when they get stuck in an assassination attempt and coup on President Vanegas, sending them into the jungles of this make-believe country with no identity or history that can be seen on screen at all other than foreign place. So there's an oppressive nothingness to Freelance. No romance, no comedy, no action. Sure, there are half-hearted attempts at both those things, but none of it connects because this film doesn't have an ounce of artistry behind it. I'm a sucker for a fun rom-com adventure movie. I even kinda like The Lost City, and a fan of John Cena's brand of action hero in most of Brie's entire career, and I found that the experience of Freelance draining. The various parts needed for a film like this, chemistry between performers, believable stakes, unexpected action beats are missing. So it's like watching an outline for a film instead of the final product. The opposite was once true for Morel, who burst onto the scene with District 13, a movie that explodes with life in every frame. He then cemented his potential as an international action director with Taken. But that filmmaker appears to have been sended down by the industry, left here to paint by numbers with boring cinematography and complete lack of cultural depth and uninspired action. At a certain point, even the actors start to look bored when Brie's character says, "That's pretty cool," and look as Cena's like, "Both of them know they are in a movie," I mutter, "I don't believe you." Pierre Morel's Freelance follows disgraced American journalist Claire Wellington and her ex-military bodyguard Mason as he escorts her to the fictional South American country of Paldonia for an exclusive interview with its dark dictator Juan Vanegas. While the film starts out by presenting Paldonia and its leader as unrepentantly evil, among other things, we are told that Vanegas is responsible for the death of half of Mason's former squad years earlier. It eventually reveals that various imperialist forces and corporate-funded mercenary groups have been actively undermining Vanegas as a means of forcing him to sell valuable natural resources for a cheaper rate. That's a surprising turn of events, especially for an action comedy given Hollywood's typically simplistic representations of underdeveloped countries whose conditions are presented as justification for American intervention. Sorry. Regrettably, that's the only surprise to be found in Jacob Lentz's screenplay, whose stabs at humor are so poorly conceived that they rarely qualify as such, and even when they do, they're more likely to elicit groans, such as a recurring and painfully ironic crack about Mason being petite. So what's worse, though, is the haphazard manner with which the filmmakers constantly juxtapose these lighter moments with more dire scenarios, with the former frequently undercutting the latter's intended gravitas. The film's romance plot, such as it is no less egregious, and in no small part due to the void of chemistry between the three leads. The few times that Vanegas hits on Claire are meant to show him as both charming and non-threatening when he's actually just over objectifying her. Meanwhile, the inevitable flirtations between Claire and Mason not only come out of nowhere, but are swiftly cut short when Mason realizes that he is still in love with his strange wife. So such a quad, Ultimately pointless scenes are par for the course in Freelance, a film that doesn't seem to know what it wants to be. By its conclusion, what we are left with is a cinematic Frankenstein, whose disparate genre elements have been cobbled together without much consideration or fuss. As such, the film ultimately feels as aimless as it does airless. Too bleak for its more serious messaging, too lent, and not nearly funny enough to make you forget it. You know, I often try not to judge a book by its cover, but when I saw the poster for Freelance, I didn't have high hopes. John Cena is always cast in the same role, and though I usually enjoy it, I had a bad feeling from the start, unfortunately. My intuition was very, very right. The premise is simple and has been done before. Many times, even as recently as The Last City with Sandra Bullock, Channing Tatum, and Daniel Radcliffe in Freelance. John Cena plays Mason, a retired special force op who had a traumatic accident, now living an unfulfilling suburban life with a failing marriage. He takes a one-time job to protect a tarnished journalist. Mason is protecting Claire as she heads out to give an exclusive interview to dictator Joan Venegas. So within hours of being there, a military coup breaks out and they need to fight their way to safety. Basically, girl needs protection. Boy protects girl. Some semblance of an attempted love story. The end. But with a political spin that had me a bit worried at the start. The beginning of Freelance is all shot with what looks like a low-quality GoPro, aiming to put us in Mason's shoes and go through what he is going through. The shaky camera style really just felt subpar. It was more distracting than anything. It felt like dictator Pierre Morel wanted us to feel a lot more than we did. Freelance had a tendency to feel like the team was aiming for a hardcore action film with a new laughs here and there, when in reality it felt like I was watching a high budget Ernest Goes to the Jungle film. I have enjoyed Cena's performance in things like The Suicide Squad and Vacation Friends, but in Freelance it felt like he was a parody of himself. I often thought that instead of a special ops performance, Cena was giving us more WWE than anything. Whether it was the direction, writing, or acting itself, I can't quite pin down. But poorly timed jokes, cartoon-like facial expressions, and next to no chemistry with anyone in the film made a film I knew would be campy. Downright brutal to sit through. The only time I felt Cena did have chemistry in the film was during the outtakes when he had a playful back and forth with Juan Pablo Raba, who plays John Vanegas. The hardest I laughed during the whole film. I adore Alison Brie and love that she is being considered for sexy leading woman roles rather than the sweet and innocent girl next door we usually see from her. However, nothing about the script or chemistry in Freelance really gave her a chance to show that off. So there is a scene where Claire tries to enter Mason, and it is just an awkward moment no one wants to be part of. So there were creative choices not to follow the usual formula in a movie of this type, where boy falls for girl. Though I can see they were trying to break the mold here and make Mason a family man. I almost wish they had have just gone for it, so we could see some connection between these characters. Vanegas often hits her on her, and she seems flattered but then tries to further the relationship with Mason, which makes little to no sense. Speaking of Venegas, John Pablo Raba was for By far the best part of Freelance. His character is lovable even though, from the beginning, we are set up to avoid trusting him. So his comedic timing is on par point, and he carries most of the scenes he is in, even when every performance around him falters. Usually, this kind of action comedy brings a certain level of cheesiness to the screen, but is often saved by big budget special effects. Unfortunately for Freelance, its massive budget couldn't save it. During several scenes, I was taken back by how bad that CGI was. In one scene, a helicopter comes crashing down, only to have a small branch on a fallen log completely stop the helicopter blades from spinning. So the practical effects weren't better, with blood spurting being completely unconvincing. Oh, and Christian Slater was there too, but we know why. Absolutely not. He likely shot the majority of his performance in one sitting. The average Joey could have played his character off the stage and viewers wouldn't have batted an eye. So his character was yet another attempt at misdirection, and he just left me asking why. I will say that the Freelancer brings a bit of political spin into this story. While, with other words, current climate, I thought the film would be trending dangerous waters. It was a new take that showed different sides of the political story. Do I think people will be happy? We want to sympathize with the dictator? Probably not, but I did. Yep. I also enjoyed the final showdown, though I don't believe it was entirely logical. It was a welcomed, fresh take. Freelance started to take a familiar action comedy formula and bend and shape it into something new, with moments that felt like the team was taking itself too seriously. Performances that felt like no more than slapstick comedy, and special effects that ripped viewers out of the moment. I had called Freelance a must miss this year. So it's never a good thing when the blooper reel running over a movie's credits demonstrates more energy, humor, and charisma than the preceding 2 hours. Sorry. So which is unfortunately the case with Pierre Morel's action comedy Freelance. It isn't until the credit rolls that we see a bit of spark from the usually delightful Alison Brie, or evidence that John Cena can riff. So there is also a telltale clue in these bloopers as well. A green screen shot with a bit of foliage dangling in the corner of the frame as John Pablo Raga mugs for the camera, which explains why so many exterior shots look so uncanny. Finally, everything about Freelance starts to make sense. Or does it make even less sense? The confounding bizarre and punishingly dull Freelance isn't really a comedy. And while there is some action, nothing ever gets the blood pumping. But it looks and sounds like an action comedy in the vein of The Lost City, which was, of course, made in the mold of Romancing the Stone. But the script by Jacob Lentz clearly wanted to be more of a serious political commentary before it was molded to fit the capabilities of its stars. John Cena stars as Mason, whom we got to know in a series of POV shots in the opening credits. A rambunctious kid who just wants to help people, he ends up going the traditional route and becoming a lawyer and getting married before he gives it up for boot camp and in a tour in the special forces. A tragic incident in the fictional South American country of Poldonia leaves him injured and grieving, and he is grounded back in the suburbs with his wife and kid, working as a lawyer and battling suburban ennui. He is called back up by his buddy Sebastian to work a private security gig for disgraced journalist Claire Wellington, who is trying to get back on her feet by landing a coveted interview with Paldonian President Venegas. On the outs with his family, Mason jumps at the chance. Paldonia, you see, if you can't see the mid-film reveal coming a mile away, it's time to watch more movies. So this is all the tortured but swift setup to get where we are going. John Cena and Alison Brie dashing through the jungle under heavy artillery fires, courtesy of a conveniently timed military coup. So Cena and Brie sweetly arguing in the jungle with occasional gun battles. That's why you're all here, right? So this brightly lit, green screen heavy film is laden with overused tropes, but light on energy and char. So there was a Latin lover, President Venegas, with blindly white teeth to match his crisp white suit, and the sultry journalist, a career mad woman who will stop at nothing for her scoop, detail, except for maybe a role in the he with whichever man is sleeping closest to her. So there is the bad guy who details all of his past wrongdoings to the hero while in the middle of a brawl. Undergirding all of this is a surprisingly cynical political story about the outside influence of global corporate entities in South America, the exploitation of natural resources in vulnerable countries, and optically driven political machinations in the vein of Wag the Dog. It feels like Lentz's script could have been something far darker and more savagely satirical, but instead, Freelance is this incredibly goofy jumble of tones. A movie that doesn't know what it is or what it wants to be, flailing about as it far overstays its welcome. So there's no need to hire this contractor. Freelance is an insipid amalgamation of tired action tropes and lackluster comedy. This movie is strung together by both a paper-thin plot and an uninspired direction. From start to finish, the film is an exercise in mediocrity, offering nothing more than a jumbled mess of cliches and wooden performances. Freelance plot, if it can even be called that, evolves around Mason. Mason is a retired special forces operator turned bodyguard tasked with protecting journalist Claire Wellington. So Claire is on an active assignment to conduct an interview with President John Venegas of the fictional nation of Paldonia. Sorry. A predictable coup erupts in the nation, and the trio finds themselves escaping into the jungle. A trio then finds themselves setting off on a journey that lacks any sense of actual urgency or tension. So one of the most glaring issues with Freelance is its complete lack of originality. So the film shamelessly borrows elements from countless other action comedies. The problem is that Freelance fails to introduce anything fresh or new into its narrative to help. So the characters are flat out one-dimensional. Mason is the typical brooding action hero, and Claire Wellington is the worn-out damsel in distress stereotyped. Even the attempt to introduce an AI-generated character falls flat, adding nothing substantial to the storytelling. Pierre Morel, once celebrated for his energetic direction in the films like District 13 and Taken, delivers a shockingly lackluster performance here. The action sequences lack the adrenaline-pumping excitement that Morel was once known for. Instead, in Freelance, we see a formulaic approach that fails to deliver anything engaging to the audience. The cinematography is equally uninspired, with generic shots of the jungle failing to capture any sense of awe or wonder. The lack of culture nuance in portraying Paldonia as a faceless generic foreign land further highlights film's lazy approach to world building. Performances in Freelance are as lifeless as the script itself. John Cena, known for his charisma and physicality, sleepwalks through the role of Mason. His attempts at emotional depth come across as forced, and his chemistry with Alison Brie's character is non-existent. Brie, despite her talent, is given little to work with. She is reduced to delivering lines devoid of any genuine emotion or wit. The supporting cast, including Juan Pablo Raba, is equally forgettable, and their performances are overshadowed by the film's lackluster writing. The attempts at humor in Freelance are cringeworthy at best, relying on tired jokes and awkward situations that fail to elicit genuine laughter. The romantic subplot between Mason and Claire is forced and lacks any semblance of chemistry, making it difficult to invest in their relationship or care about their fate. Freelance is a prime example of how not to make an action comedy film. It lacks originality, energy, and emotional depth, resulting in a viewing experience that is both tedious and forgettable. For audiences seeking a genuinely entertaining and well-crafted action comedy, Freelance is a hard pass. Save your time and money for a time film that offers something more than a haphazard assembly of tired clichés and uninspired performances. Attentive viewers will discern some positive moral values underlying the plot of the action comedy Freelance. The difficulty is that such audience concentration on this slipshod film will also reveal its subpar status, even as a source of casual entertainment. John Cena starts as He-Man Mason, as explained in an opening voiceover, convinced that he would be bored with family life in the suburbs. Youthful law school student Mason suddenly abandoned his studies to become an army ranger instead. Unlikely choice turned out to be a good one, since Mason loved being in the military. But when a mission to overthrow Juan Venegas, the notorious dictator of the fictional South American nation of Caledonia, went horribly awry, Mason was so badly wounded that he had to leave the service and return to the civilian world. Fast forward to the present, and Mason has acquired a wife Jenny, and a daughter Cassie. But his career has stayed stalled, and he is so stultified and restless that it's taking a lot on his marriage. So when his friend and former comrade Sebastian, who now has a security outfit, offers him a temporary job, Mason is initially open to the idea. However, on learning that his task will be to serve as bodyguard to reporter Claire Wellington during a journey to Caledonia, where Venegas has offered the journalist a rare interview, Mason hesitates when Sebastian throws a large fee into the balance, though he does the trick and Mason agrees to that. No sooner do Mason and Claire land in Caledonia than a coup breaks out, and the presidential limo in which they are riding is ambushed. Predictably, Mason succeeds in beating back the onslaught and saving both Claire and Venegas. But this leaves the trio wandering around in the jungle while Mason trades fire with uniformed extras to no particular purpose. As scripted by Jacob Lentz and directed by Pierre Morel, Freelance eventually pushes back against Mason's cynicism about domestic tranquility, vindicating the value of marital fidelity and clan reconciliation. But the movie's forays into geopolitics and global economics are naively simplistic, with America depicted as the world's manipulative bad guy. So by the time the credit roll, Morel has staged a large-scale climactic showdown that litters the ground with corpses, and the gunplay by which they and their numerous predecessors in early scenes are laid low is sometimes quite graphic. So blending this mayhem with humor drawing when Vanegas' savvy and the cross purposes at which Bassin and Clear are constantly working makes for an unstable tone, seemingly uncertain where it wants to end up. The picture spins its wheels and in the end goes nowhere. The film contains considerable violence, brief rear nudity, anatomical humor, a couple of profanities, a few milder oaths. Travel uses each of rough and crude language and an obscene gesture. The OSV News classification is A3 adults. So Motion Picture Association rating is R, restricted. Under 17 requires accompanying parents or adult guardians. So it's never a good thing when the blogger reel running over a movie's cadence demonstrates more energy, humor, and charisma than the preceding 2 hours. Which is unfortunately the case with Pierre Morel's action comedy Freelance. It isn't until the credits roll that we see a bit of spark from the usually delightful Alison Brie, or evidence that John Cena can riff. There is also a telltale clue in these bloopers as well. A green screen studio shot with a bit of foliage dangling in the corner of the frame as Juan Pablo Raga mugs for the camera, which explains why so many exterior shots look so uncanny. Finally, everything about Freelance starts to make sense. Or does it make even less sense? The confounding, bizarre, and punishingly dull Freelance isn't really a comedy. And while there is some action, nothing ever gets the blood pumping. It looks and sounds like an action comedy, and in the vein of The Lost City, which was of course made in the mold of Romancing the Stone. But the script by Jacob Lentz clearly wanted to be more of a serious political commentary, because before it was shaped to fit the capabilities of its stars. Cena stars as Mason, whom we get to know in a series of POV shots in the opening credits. An ambitious kid who just wants to help people. He ends up going the traditional route and becoming a lawyer and getting married before he gives it up for boot camp and a tour in a special forces. A tragic incident in the fictional South American country of Paldonia leaves him injured and grieving, and he is grounded back in the suburbs with his wife and kid, working as an attorney and battling suburban ennui. This brightly fit film is laden with overused tropes but light on energy and charm. So there was a Latin lover, President Venegas, with blindly white teeth to match his crisp white suit, and a sultry journalist, a career-mad woman who will stop at nothing for her scoop data, except for maybe a roll in the hay with whichever man is sleeping closest to her. So there is a bad guy who details all of his past wrongdoings to the hero while in the middle of a brawl. Undergirding all of this is a surprisingly cynical political story about the outsized influence of global corporate entities in South America, the exploitation of natural resources in vulnerable countries, and optically driven political machinations in the vein of Wag the Dog. Sorry. So it feels like Lang's script could have been something far darker and more savagely satirical, but instead Freelance is an incredibly goofy jumble of tones, flailing about. As it overstays its welcome, there is no need to hire this contractor. Freelance is barely a movie. Sure, it's got a budget, a semblance of a plot and stars that you will recognize, but none of it was developed beyond the bare minimum to get released on VOD and in a few theaters. It's a definitely lazy work, a project that echoes better films when it's doing anything. The most impressive thing about Pierre Morel's film is how it takes two actors as generally likable as John Cena and Alison Brie and makes them such blind avatars for actual people that they feed into the dull background of action comedy noise this movie tries to achieve. John Cena plays the AI name-generated Mason, a former special ops soldier who is introduced on a mission gone horribly awry. So after all, he needs some trauma as a defining character trait. Well, that ain't a rocky marriage, ain't. Consistently quizzical look, like when my dog hears a word she knows. Sorry. Mason is approached by his former boss for a job as the bodyguard for a journalist named Claire Wellington. And she travels to a fictional war-torn country named Poldonia to interview the president, John Vanegas. Shortly after arrival, they are thrust into action when they get stuck in an assassination attempt and coup on President Vanegas, sending them into the jungles of this make-believe country with no identity or history that can be seen on screen at all other than foreign place. So there's an oppressive nothingness to Freelance. No romance, no comedy, no action. Sure, there are half-hearted attempts at both those things, but none of it connects because this film doesn't have an ounce of artistry behind it. I'm a sucker for a fun rom-com adventure movie. I even kinda liked The Lost City, and a fan of John Cena's brand of action hero in most of Brie's entire career, and I found that the experience of Freelance draining. The various parts needed for a film like this, chemistry between performers, believable stakes, unexpected action beats are missing. So it's like watching an outline for a film instead of the final product. The opposite was once true for Morel, who burst onto the scene with District 13, a movie that explodes with life in every frame. He then cemented his potential as an international action director with Taken. But that filmmaker appears to have been sended down by the industry, left here to paint by numbers with boring cinematography and complete lack of cultural depth and uninspired action. At a certain point, even the actors start to look bored when Brie's character says, "That's pretty cool." And look, as Cena's like, "Both of them know they are in a movie," I muttered, "I don't believe you." Pierre Morel's Freelance follows disgraced American journalist Claire Wellington and her ex-military bodyguard Mason as he escorts her to the fictional South American country of Paldonia for an exclusive interview with its dark dictator, Juan Vanegas. While the film starts out by presenting Paldonia and its leader as unrepentantly evil, among other things, we are told that Vanegas is responsible for the death of half of Mason's former squad years earlier. It eventually reveals that various imperialist forces and corporate-funded mercenary groups have been actively undermining Vanegas as a means of forcing him to sell valuable natural resources for a cheaper rate. That's a surprising turn of events, especially for an action comedy given Hollywood's typically simplistic representations of underdeveloped countries whose conditions are presented as justification for American intervention. Sorry. Regrettably, that's the only surprise to be found in Jacob Lentz's screenplay, whose stabs at humor are so poorly conceived that they rarely qualify as such, and even when they do, they're more likely to elicit groans, such as a recurring and painfully ironic crack about Mason being petite. So what's worse, though, is the haphazard manner with which the filmmakers constantly juxtapose these lighter moments with more dire scenarios, with the former frequently undercutting the latter's intended gravitas. The film's romance plot, such as it is no less egregious, and in no small part due to the void of chemistry between the three leads. The few times that Vanegas hits on Claire are meant to show him as both charming and non-threatening when He's actually just over objectifying her. Meanwhile, the inevitable flirtations between Claire and Mason not only come out of nowhere, but are swiftly cut short when Mason realizes that he is still in love with his estranged wife. So such a quad and ultimately pointless scenes are par for the course in Freelance, a film that doesn't seem to know what it wants to be. By its conclusion, what we are left with is a cinematic Frankenstein, whose disparate genre elements have been cobbled together without much consideration or fuss. As such, the film ultimately feels as aimless as it does airless. Too bleak for its more serious messaging, too lame, and not nearly funny enough to make you forget it. You know, I often try not to judge a book by its cover, but when I saw the poster for Freelance, I didn't have high hopes. John Cena is always cast in the same role, and though I usually enjoy it, I had a bad feeling from the start, unfortunately. My intuition was very, very right. The premise is simple and has been done before. Many times, even as recently as The Last City with Sandra Bullock, Channing Tatum and Daniel Radcliffe in Freelance. John Cena plays Mason, a retired special force op who had a traumatic accident, now living an unfulfilling suburban life with a failing marriage. He takes a one-time job to protect a tarnished journalist. Mason is protecting Claire as she heads out to give an exclusive interview to dictator Juan Venegas. So within hours of being there, a military coup breaks out and they need to fight their way to safety. Basically, girl needs protection. Boy protects girl. Some semblance of an attempted love story. The end. But with a political spin that had me a bit worried at the start. The beginning of Freelance is all shot with what looks like a low-quality GoPro, aiming to put us in Mason's shoes and go through what he is going through. The shaky camera style really just felt subpar. It was more distracting than anything. I felt like dictator Pierre Morel wanted us to feel a lot more than we did. Freelance had a tendency to feel like the team was aiming for a hardcore action film, with a new laughs here and there, when in reality, it felt like I was watching a high-budget Ernest Goes to the Jungle film. I have enjoyed Cena's performance in things like The Suicide Squad and Vacation Friends. But in Freelance, it felt like he was a parody of himself. I often thought that instead of a special ops performance, Cena was giving us more WWE than anything. Whether it was the direction, writing, or acting itself, I can't quite pin down. But poorly timed jokes, cartoon-like facial expressions, and next to no chemistry with anyone in the film made a film I knew would become be downright brutal to sit through. The only time I felt Cena did have chemistry in the film was during the outtakes when he had a playful back and forth with Juan Pablo Raba, who plays Juan Venegas, the hardest I laughed during the whole film. I adore Alison Brie and love that she is being considered for sexy leading woman roles rather than the sweet and innocent girl next door we usually see from her. However, nothing about the script or chemistry in Freelance really gave her a chance to show that off. So there is a scene where Claire tries to enter Mason, and it is just an awkward moment no one wants to be part of. So there were creative choices not to follow the usual formula in a movie of this type, where boy falls for girl. Though I can see they were trying to break the mold here and make Mason a family man. I almost wish they had have just gone for it, so we could see some connection between these characters. Vanegas often hits her on her, and she seems flattered but then tries to further the relationship with Mason, which makes little to no sense. Speaking of Vanegas, John Pablo Raba was by far the best part of Freelance. His character is lovable even though, from the beginning, we are set up to avoid trusting him. So his comedic timing is on par point, and he carries most of the scenes he is in, even when every performance around him falters. Usually, this kind of action comedy brings a certain level of cheesiness to the screen, but is often saved by big-budget special effects. Unfortunately for Freelance, its massive budget couldn't save it. During several scenes, I was taken back by how bad that CGI was. In one scene, a helicopter comes crashing down, only to have a small branch on a fallen log completely stop the helicopter blades from spinning. So the practical effects weren't better with Bloodsporting being completely unconvincing. Oh, and Christian Slater was there too, but we know why. Absolutely not. He likely shot the majority of his performance in one sitting. The average Joey could have played his character off the stage and viewers wouldn't have batted an eye. So his character was yet another attempt at misdirection, and he just left me asking why. I will say that The Freelancer brings a bit of political spin into this story. While, with other words, current climate, I thought the film would be trending dangerous waters. It was a new take that showed different sides of the political story. Do I think people will be happy? We want to sympathize with the dictator? Probably not, but I did. Yep. I also enjoyed the final showdown, though I don't believe it was entirely logical. It was a welcomed, fresh take. Freelance started to take a familiar action comedy formula and bend and shape it into something new, with moments that felt like the team was taking itself too seriously. Performances that felt like no more than slapstick comedy, and special effects that ripped viewers out of the moment I had called Freelance the most miss this year. So it's never a good thing when the blooper reel running over a movie's credits demonstrates more energy, humor, and charisma than the preceding 2 hours. Sorry. So which is unfortunately the case with Pierre Morel's action comedy Freelance. It isn't until the credit rolls that we see a bit of spark from the usually delightful Alison Brie, or evidence that John Cena can riff. So there is also a telltale clue in these bloopers as well. A green screen shot with a bit of foliage dangling in the corner of the frame as John Pablo Raga mugs for the camera, which explains why so many exterior shots look so uncanny. Finally, everything about Freelance starts to make sense. Or does it make even less sense? The confounding bizarre and punishingly dull Freelance isn't really a comedy. And while there is some action, nothing ever gets the blood pumping. But it looks and sounds like an action comedy in the vein of The Lost City, which was, of course, made in the mold of Romancing the Stone. But the script by Jacob Lentz clearly wanted to be more of a serious political commentary before it was molded to fit the capabilities of its stars. John Cena stars as Mason, whom we get to know in a series of POV shots in the opening credits. A rambunctious kid who just wants to help people, he ends up going the traditional route and becoming a lawyer and getting married before he gives it up for boot camp and in a tour in the special forces. A tragic incident in the fictional South American country of Poldonia leaves him injured and grieving, and he is grounded back in the suburbs with his wife and kid, working as a lawyer and battling suburban ennui. He is called back up by his buddy Sebastian to work a private security gig for disgraced journalist Claire Wellington, who is trying to get back on her feet by landing a coveted interview with Paldonian President Venegas. On the outs with his family, Mason jumps at the chance. Paldonia, you see, if you can't see the mid-film reveal coming a mile away, it's time to watch more movies. So this is all the tortured but swift setup to get where we are going. John Cena and Alison Brie dashing through the jungle under heavy artillery fires, courtesy of a conveniently timed military coup. So Cena and Brie sweetly arguing in the jungle with occasional gun battles. That's why you're all here, right? So this brightly lit green screen heavy film is laden with overused tropes, but light on energy and charm. So there was a Latin lover, President Venegas, with blindly white teeth to match his crisp white suit, and the sultry journalist, a career mad woman who will stop at nothing for her scoop, dictate, except for maybe a role in the he with whichever man is sleeping closest to her. So there is the bad guy who details all of his past wrongdoings to the hero while in the middle of a brawl. Undergirding all of this is a surprisingly cynical political story about the outside influence of global corporate entities in South America, the exploitation of natural resources in vulnerable countries, and optically driven political machinations in the vein of Wag the Dog. It feels like Lang's script could have been something far darker and more savagely satirical, but instead, Freelance is this incredibly goofy jumble of tones. A movie that doesn't know what it is or what it wants to be, flailing about as it far overstays its welcome. So there's no need to hire this contractor. Freelance is an insipid amalgamation of tired action tropes and lackluster comedy. This movie is strung together by both a paper-thin plot and an uninspired direction. From start to finish, the film is an exercise in mediocrity, offering nothing more than a jumbled mess of glitches and wooden performances. Freelance plot, if it can even be called that, evolves around Mason. Mason is a retired special forces operator turned bodyguard tasked with protecting journalist Claire Wellington. So Claire is on an active assignment to conduct an interview with President John Vanegas of the fictional nation of Paldania. Sorry. A predictable coup erupts in the nation, and the trio finds themselves escaping into the jungle. Our trio then finds themselves setting off on a journey that lacks any sense of actual urgency or tension. So one of the most glaring issues with Freelance is its complete lack of originality. So the film shamelessly borrows elements from countless other action comedies. The problem is that Freelance fails to introduce anything fresh or new into its narrative to help. So the characters are flat out one-dimensional. Mason is the typical brooding action hero, and Claire Wellington is the worn-out damsel in distress stereotyped. Even the attempt to introduce an AI-generated character falls flat, adding nothing substantial to the storytelling. Pierre Morel, once celebrated for his energetic direction in the films like District 13 and Taken, delivers a shockingly lackluster performance here. The action sequences lack the adrenaline-pumping excitement that Morel was once known for. Instead, in Freelance, we see a formulaic approach that fails to deliver anything engaging to the audience. The cinematography is equally uninspired, with generic shots of the jungle failing to capture any sense of awe or wonder. The lack of culture nuance in portraying Paldonia as a faceless generic foreign land further highlights film's lazy approach to world building. The performances in Freelance are as lifeless as the script itself. John Cena, known for his charisma and physicality, sleepwalks through the role of Mason. His attempts at emotional depth come across as forced, and his chemistry with Alison Brie's character is non-existent. Brie, despite her talent, is given little to work with. She is reduced to delivering lines devoid of any genuine emotion or wit. The supporting cast, including Juan Pablo Raba, is equally forgettable, and their performances are overshadowed by the film's lackluster writing. The attempts at humor in Freelance are cringeworthy at best, relying on tired jokes and awkward situations that fail to elicit genuine laughter. The romantic subplot between Mason and Claire is forced and lacks any semblance of chemistry, making it difficult to invest in their relationship or care about their fate. Freelance is a prime example of how not to make an action comedy film. It lacks originality, energy, and emotional depth, resulting in a viewing experience that is both tedious and forgettable. For audiences seeking a genuinely entertaining and well-crafted action comedy, Freelance is a hard pass. Save your time and money for a time film that offers something more than a haphazard assembly of tired glitches and uninspired performances. Attentive viewers will discern some positive moral values underlying the plot of the action comedy Freelance. The difficulty is that such audience concentration on this slipshod film will also reveal its subpar status, even as a source of casual entertainment. John Cena starts as He-Man Mason, as explained in an opening voiceover, convinced that he would be bored with family life in the suburbs. Youthful law school student Mason suddenly abandoned his studies to become an Army Ranger instead. Unlikely choice turned out to be a good one, since Mason loved being in the military. But when a mission to overthrow Juan Vanegas the notorious dictator of the fictional South American nation of Caledonia, went horribly awry. Mason was so badly wounded that he had to leave the service and return to the civilian world. Fast forward to the present, and Mason has acquired a journey, a wife Jenny, and a daughter Cassie. But his career has stayed stalled, and he is so stultified and restless that it's taking a lot on his marriage. So when his friend and former comrade Sebastian, who now has a security outfit, offers him a temporary job, Mason is initially open to the idea. However, on learning that his task will be to serve as bodyguard to reporter Claire Wellington during a journey to Caledonia, where Venegas has offered the journalist a rare interview, Mason hesitates when Sebastian throws a large fee into the balance, though he does the trick and Mason agrees to that. No sooner do Mason and Claire land in Caledonia than a coup breaks out and the presidential limo in which they are riding is ambushed. Predictably, Mason succeeds in beating back the onslaught and saving both Claire and Venegas. But this leaves the trio wandering around in the jungle while Mason trades fire with uniformed extras to no particular purpose. As scripted by Jacob Lentz and directed by Pierre Morel, Freelance eventually pushes back against Mason's cynicism about domestic tranquility, vindicating the value of marital fidelity and clan reconciliation. But the movie's forays into geopolitics and global economics are naively simplistic, with America depicted as the world's manipulative bad guy. So by the time the credit roll, Morel has staged a large-scale climactic showdown that litters the ground with corpses and the gunplay by which they and their numerous predecessors in early scenes are laid low is sometimes quite graphic. So blending this mayhem with humor drawing when Vanegas savvy and the cross purposes at which Mason and Claire are constantly working makes for an unstable tone. Seemingly uncertain where it wants to end up, the picture spins its wheels and in the end goes nowhere. The film contains considerable violence, brief rear nudity, anatomical humor, a couple of profanities, a few milder oaths. Travel uses each of rough and crude language and an obscene gesture. The OSV News classification is A3 adults. So Motion Picture Association rating is R, restricted. Under 17 requires accompanying parents or adult guardians. So it's never a good thing when the blogger reel running over a movie's credits demonstrates more energy, humor, and charisma than the preceding 2 hours, which is unfortunately the case with Pierre Morel's action comedy Freelance. It isn't until the credits roll that we see a bit of spark from the hugely delightful Alison Brie, or evidence that John Cena can riff. There is also a telltale clue in these bloopers as well. A green screen studio shot with a bit of foliage dangling in the corner of the frame as Juan Pablo Raga mugs for the camera, which explains why so many exterior shots look so uncanny. Finally, everything about Freelance starts to make sense. Or does it make even less sense? The confounding, bizarre, and punishingly dull Freelance isn't really a comedy. And while there is some action, nothing ever gets the blood pumping. But it looks and sounds like an action comedy, and in the vein of The Lost City, which was of course made in the mold of Romancing the Stone. But the script by Jacob Lentz clearly wanted to be more of a serious political commentary, because before it was shaped to fit the capabilities of its stars. Cena stars as Mason, whom we get to know in a series of POV shots in the opening credits. An ambitious kid who just wants to help people. He ends up going the traditional route and becoming a lawyer and getting married before he gives it up for boot camp and a tour in special forces. A tragic incident in the fictional South American country of Caledonia leaves him injured and grieving, and he is grounded back in the suburbs with his wife and kid, working as an attorney and battling suburban ennui. This brightly fit film is laden with overused tropes but light on energy and charm. So there was a Latin lover, President Venegas, with blindingly white teeth to match his crisp white suit, and a sultry journalist, a career-mad woman who will stop at nothing for her scoop data, except for maybe a role in the hay with whichever man is sleeping closest to her. So there was a bad guy who details all of his past wrongdoings to the hero while in the middle of a brawl. Undergirding all of this is a surprisingly cynical political story about the outsized influence of global corporate entities in South America, exploitation of natural resources in vulnerable countries, and optically driven political machinations in the vein of Wag the Dog. Sorry. It feels like Lang's script could have been something far darker and more savagely satirical, but instead Freelance is an incredibly goofy jumble of tones, flailing about. As it overstays its welcome, there is no need to hire this contractor.